Seems we're not quite done with the new Elizabeth line. There's one more film to make, and whenever I go out filming, I always wear this grey top, and I tend to wear this two-tone, dark grey and light grey fleece with this red trim. And that's Jeff, isn't it? That's Jeff in a Jeff video out on the trains. Not today. Today, we're going to do something a little bit special. Today, I'm wearing a suit, just because sometimes you gotta. I think the sunglasses might be too much though. Come on. So I've got a list of 10 things that I've come up with, observations in the last was it May 24th that it opened on that Tuesday? And since then, just some things have come to mind, some thoughts about the new railway across purple train. With 10 stations, I thought I'd do 10 at each one. Straight away, I've come here to Paddington, and the thing for me which really like makes it show how amazing this purple train is when you compare it to the tube line. Suddenly you come here to Bakerloo on a little tiny six-car train on a narrow platform with narrow passageways, and the Bakerloo line seems really old, antiquated and dilapidated compared to this, the amazing new Liz line purple train Paddington station. This feels incredible, and it makes the tube seem very, very old.
This is the train to Abbey Wood. Seat, safe, sorted.
Hanover Square, just down from Oxford Circus, and this here will be the eastern entrance to Bond Street Station. Now, I've just walked between the stairs at the top there down to here. That takes about 2 minutes, so I think that this will be an OSI when Bond Street opens. Yes, we've got all that to come. And also, trains will go straight through at Paddington at some point. They're saying autumn. There's a poster over there right now that's saying autumn. I think October. But my point is that if you've been excited so far as to the opening of the Elizabeth line, we're going to do it all over again come October when trains go straight through and Bond Street opens, and it's just going to be amazing and fun once more. So you've still got that to look forward to another time on the railways when it's going to be very exciting. Number three, we're at Tottenham Court Road. That is an eastbound train going that way. And the signs are, that already what they do here on Crossrail, Elizabeth line, is a little bit like what they do on the tube, because if you wanted to go to the northern line at this point, I've learned that the quickest way is to go down this corridor, but there's a sign up here that tells you to keep going and then takes you left and then back in yourself and then to the northern line. So we've got a whole world to discover where, as per on the tube set at King's Cross, the signs don't always tell you the fastest way to go. Made it to Farringdon. Will you be forgiven for thinking that because I'm wearing my nice new suit, I won't slide onto the floor? But you'd be wrong. On the floor down here, I want to make a very controversial opinion about the tube map, and one which I thought I would never make. On the official tube map, they have the overground as cased parallel orange lines, they have the DLR also as those parallel lines, and the new Elizabeth line is in purple, but again, going west to east, horizontal, in those parallel lines. And I think it doesn't stand out very well, say, compared to the boldness, the filled in of the central line. However, and obviously I'm throwing up graphics on screen now, if you look at the London Rail and Tube Services map, which is a different map, they've always shaded the overground orange, and they've always shaded the DLR in like a solid teal colour, and they've also shaded the new Elizabeth line in a solid purple. And I think it looks better. So even though it might make you think that it's an underground line when it's not, I actually wish that on the tube map, the Elizabeth line was filled in full coloured purple. Liverpool Street for my next quick point, which is at the exit. It's always at the extreme end, either the western or the eastern end, with the exception of Whitechapel, which only has the one exit. Therefore, there's a great argument that says, is the quietest part of the train the bit in the middle, because people have learned to be at the ends for where the exits are, or actually, is it better to be in the middle if you don't know where the exit is, and then it's an equidistant walk to get to the exit that you want? So maybe until you learn which exit you want, sit in the middle, and once you've learned which exit you want, make sure you're always at the front or towards the back of the train, because that's where the exit's going to be. Right, give us a wave, Chanel. Woo! How are you enjoying the train?
It's great.
Loving it. Bye.
Bye.
A quick stop at Whitechapel to discuss escalators and lifts. There are a couple of stations you might want to ascertain which ones they are for yourself, but sometimes I think it's quicker to get the lift to the platform rather than get the escalator to the platform. The escalator isn't always the fastest way. Out of all the videos that I've made over the last week or two, this was my favourite moment with my friend Keith, where he went action and went, I don't know why either, you're allowed to come through there. And it's fun, it's nice, I like it, that I've already got a favourite moment and a favourite memory, and potentially in Canary Wharf maybe a favourite station. And it's stations and the railway that I want to talk about next, because there have been some detractors, there have been some negative comments, there have been some people in real life that just simply say, it's just a new railway, it's just a new train line, it's just a new tube line. Get over yourself. To which I say, for many people, you know, a lot of the viewers on this YouTube channel, it's more than just trains. Going for a train ride, as I've said before, can be a simple pleasure, which can turn a bad day into a good one. And sometimes it's more than that. Maybe you suffer from, you know, mental issues or anxiety or autism or ADHD. Maybe things like that for you mean that in a world of railways, you can find your peace and a love, and it's a hobby which you love so much that it brings you so much joy. And that is what Crossrail Purple Train Liz Line does do for many of us, bring us new joy and new excitement for London. And some people will never get that, and that's okay. They just see it as an A to B, a commute, a way to get to work. But the rest of us, we know that it's trains and it's awesome, and we should never forget that. Do you know, one day I should do a full complete video just talking about those kinds of issues. But Canary Wharf, love it. Made it to Custom House, the sun is shining, so the shades are going on. Completely gratuitous and unnecessary. There's a train there, its doors are going to beep in a minute. It's 6 o'clock, been working my way east down the line towards Abbey Wood. Just came from Canary Wharf, evening peak, where the train was really busy. Good to see. In the first week, there was some speculation that maybe it wasn't as busy, people weren't using it. People certainly are using it. Word is spreading that the line is open, up and running, it's working, it's efficient, it's going places and is getting people there quicker. And I love it, because what that basically is an advert for more railways like this. One of the comments that I see the most, and trust me, I read every comment on YouTube, is when people say, what about levelling up, Jeff? What about, yes, London gets all the railways, what about the North getting some of the railways? And I agree. What about if there was a Crossrail type scheme between, say, Liverpool and Manchester, you know, or crazily even through to like Leeds? What if there was a system which did this? It went overground between the cities but went underground. I think if you have a train like this in London showing that it can work and people use it, then that is a great advert to get it running in a similar way in other cities around the rest of the country. I would love to see other Crossrail type schemes in other cities in Britain. At 6:23 p.m. It's good to see that people coming home, everyone has learned to be at the back of the train, and there's loads of people coming up here. Woolwich is the new way to get to and from town. No one's using South Theatre anymore, everyone is using the Purple Train, and that's good to see, because it means that then there's more space on those South Eastern trains, and if it's happening here, then it's also happening on other parts of the network. So bits of the Jubilee, bits of the Central Line have been congestion busted, relieved by everybody now using the Purple Train, and that is one of the magnificent things that it does for London's commuters. had enough of the tie. Tie's coming off. I'll go back to casual. So I think it's sunny outside, it's going to be warm again. And having been underground, we're now about to go overground. We've made it to Abbey Wood, end of the line, or the beginning if you start your commute here. Shout out, by the way, to the gentleman who 2 weeks ago saw me lying on the floor of Tottenham Road Station and went, "Jeff, you're living your best life, well done." It was exhausting doing videos every 2 days, every 3 days. Those people that do daily vlogs, they must be exhausted. Anyway, we're here at Abbey Wood, randomly, just because we can. I've got my friend Pete here to turn up to play a little bit of Purple Train. Right, Pete? That's Pete. Let's also give a shout out and a mention to everyone that's worked on the Elizabeth Line. If you're an architect or an engineer or a designer or planner, or you're the people who are down on the station building it, digging holes, the construction workers, everyone today, to the gateline staff, to the cleaners, everyone that's been involved in making this new railway, this incredible new railway, which you should come and ride. Thank you for being involved, and thank you to all the staff. All the MTR staff know who I am now. When they see me, they wave and they go, "Hello, Jeff," and I'm filming on the platforms. That's fun as well. Thanks to everyone. I'll leave you with a little bit of Purple Train. What was that about the suit?
Jeff, you look so suave. It's like, it's just different. You don't normally wear this outfit. So when I see, it's like Jeff, he's wearing a nice suit. The tie's all done up. The collar looks good. I'm like, damn, that's my guy, Jeff. Okay, Jeff, I see you. I see you shining, Jeff.